I'm going to touch just briefly on ligament injuries. I think it is very difficult for a ligament injury really to be assessed accurately remotely. A ligament injury is something that's so much better to get your hands on and assess, because it's a, these are stress tests, but the history is also so, so important. I don't have time to go through all of the ligament injuries. Homa's touched in one or, well, on some parts of it, but this is a demonstration of an anterior draw test, where a top tip for this is for you to sit on the patient's foot so it's stabilized. Use your hand to actually push up into the hamstrings to relax their hamstrings, and then use your weight just to lean back and feel the tibia translate forward. Lachman test is testing the ACL also. It's a bit harder to elicit. The key again is to try to get the patient relaxed. With big knees and small hands, it's a very difficult test to do well, but it is more specific than the anterior draw test. Nowadays, any significant knee injury or any persistent knee problems, then we're going for an MRI scan really very, very early in the patient pathway. And that's, this will be through NHS or private sector. And the MRI scan will confirm the diagnosis. So that's the T1, T2 weighted images is the more useful one. You can see that the ACL here has lost its tension. There's lots of white fluid, so signal change, and it's the MRI scan shows that there's fluid in the notch here, which is where the ACL is meant to be attached. Early management of ACLs is conservative, so we do not see an ACL injury and book and proceed with surgery immediately. The patient has to rehabilitate. It's because if we go in too early to operate, there's quite a high incidence of getting a complication of the knee becoming really stiff afterwards. And so actually the early management is rehabilitation. Now, of course, in this last few months, early management has really been non-existent. So we'll just have to see what's happened to this patient cohort. They've not been able to access physio, a lot of them, but the priorities initially is about managing the swelling, regaining the motion, and getting the muscles to function. And at the end of that, when that's been achieved, we can determine whether the patient is going to require surgery or continue with a conservative pathway. This is a very famous paper. So Frobel, and I can't believe it's already 10 years old, he's a great advocate of managing ACL injuries conservatively. And he really stirred things up in the knee community by stating that basically patients can be managed conservatively and there was really no downside to this. Those that had to have an operation down the line, they can have their operation down the line. However, this paper has been the response to this paper was a barrage of orthopaedic papers to follow to highlight that although not every patient needs to have a surgical management of their anterior cruciate ligament, certainly delaying the procedure does have consequences, and the consequences are that the ACL is so important. It's stabilizing and maintaining the knee in the correct place. When the knee subluxes or gives way, then the worry is that the further damage will occur. And what there's many papers that have been published subsequently, but what we've found is that if elective surgery is delayed, then the longer it's delayed, the more likely we're going to have associated injuries to the knee. And principally, we're talking about meniscal injuries. So surgery that's performed at 6 months versus, or surgery is delayed at 6 to 12 months has a double instance of medial meniscal issues. And beyond the year mark, that increases substantially. So the general message is that if we're going to make the decision to operate, it's better that surgery is done sooner rather than later. However, sooner does not mean immediately, and the first management strategy is rehabilitation. If the patient remains symptomatic with ongoing instability, and that can be quite subtle, the patient is the best judge of this, and a patient that describes their knee as feeling unsteady, rather than having to experience episodes of the knee truly giving way, I think is good enough for us to be considering surgery. And that should be done in a timely manner. And we'll just have to see what we're going to discover in the forthcoming months of this. The barrier to healthcare is going to mean to a lot of these patients. ACL surgery is straightforward, it's routine surgery, and it works well. It works well at improving the patient's stability. It's certainly the best way to get to restore high performance recovery, and so achieving high level of sports is very difficult without surgery. But even for an average daily living activities, those that are struggling to do it with through instability, this can be corrected by an ACL reconstruction. In restoring the stability to the joint, we're able to protect the meniscus and reduce the chance of them subsequently developing degenerative changes.